Doctor, there's some blood in my poop.
Can be a sign of colorectal cancer.
So, doctor, I just wanted to know, I go to the toilet, right? And I have some blood in my poop. This one, anything to worry about?
Blood in the poop can be due to many reasons. Common ones include things like piles, anal fissures, but most importantly, sometimes it can be a sign of colorectal cancer.
Cancer? Can you tell me more about this?
Colorectal cancer is the most common cancer in Singapore.
What is colon, Dr. Sonia?
The colon is also known as the large intestine, and in fact, it's broken down into the colon and the rectum, which is the terminal part before waste is being expelled when we go to the toilet. Cancer that happens anywhere along the colon or the rectum is known as colorectal cancer.
This one sounds very serious, doctor.
Yes, it is serious if it's not promptly treated.
Okay, so now I told you I already have blood in my poop. Is there other things that I need to look out for?
So other symptoms sometimes that we should be concerned about include things like narrowing of the stools, unexplained weight loss or appetite loss over a protracted duration, things like constipation or diarrhea are all symptoms that we should be worried about and seek evaluation promptly if so.
Wow, even diarrhea, wow, this is very worrying now.
Don't worry, we'll try our best to help.
Okay, I really want to know what really causes this colorectal cancer.
Colorectal cancer typically develops as a polyp, which is an abnormal growth of tissue, and this starts in the colon or rectum. Some of the risk factors can include age, especially for people above the age of 50.
Ah, okay lah, above 50. I only early 40s now. I should be fine. I should be okay, right?
But colorectal cancer can develop in younger people. For example, Chadwick Boseman, the actor that played Black Panther, he unfortunately was diagnosed with colorectal cancer before the age of 40.
Wow, that guy looked very healthy.
But he unfortunately passed away from colorectal cancer at the age of 43.
Oh, no.
Yeah. So some of the other risk factors can include a family history of colorectal cancer, a personal history of inflammatory bowel diseases, a diet that is high in red or processed meats, smoking, obesity, and excessive consumption of alcohol.
Wow.
Okay. So all this can lead to an increased risk of colorectal cancer.
Doctor, I just wanted to find out, how do I know if I have colorectal cancer?
So colorectal cancer is usually diagnosed through a combination of history, physical examination, as well as some special tests.
Okay.
The most important test to detect colorectal cancer is that of a colonoscopy.
I see.
This is a videoscopic examination of the colon that allows us to take biopsies to prove that it is indeed cancer, but also offers the opportunity for us to remove any growths that may turn into cancer with time if left in place as well.
So doctor, my grandmother used to always say there's one soup. If I drink the soup, then there'll be no kind of cancer one. I don't know, what do you think?
Unfortunately, there's no soup in the world that can prevent colorectal cancer. What is probably most important is that we stick to screening so that if cancer is indeed present, we detect them early. Now, screening can take multiple forms. It can be in the form of a stool test called a FIT kit that looks for traces of blood within the stools. This has to be done every year. Alternatively, you can also opt to do a colonoscopy, which also gives you the opportunity to remove any precancerous growths before they turn into cancer. In SKH, we even use artificial intelligence enhanced technology to improve our detection rate of these precancerous growths.
Wow.
In fact, studies have shown that up to 20% of such growths that can be missed by the naked eye will be additionally picked up by this artificial intelligence per se.
Okay, artificial intelligence, AI, they call it.
Yes, it is.
Doctor, can I ask you, can colorectal cancer be cured?
Now, early detection and treatment can greatly increase the chance of successful cure. In most cases of colon and rectal cancer that is confined within the colon and rectum itself, surgery is usually the mainstay of therapy.
Yeah, surgery.
Yes, but not to worry. In this day and age, we use minimally invasive surgery, or what we call keyhole surgery, most of the time. This involves a smaller scar, less pain, and a much faster recovery.
Okay.
However, it may not be possible to remove all cancers that way. In certain cancers which are more advanced, we still need to defer to traditional open surgery in order to remove all the cancer cells cleanly.
In certain colorectal cancers, a stoma may be required to be created. So this is an opening on the skin of the belly in order to divert stools and managed in a stoma bag as such.
Oh, this is the bag, okay.
So while a stoma is not commonly required, our medical and nursing teams are here to support you through this journey should you require one.
Okay, thank you, thank you. I was just wondering, you know, they say after the surgery, they do surgery, they take out all the bad parts, then I'm cured already lah.
Treatment sometimes includes a course of chemotherapy as well.
What is chemotherapy?
So chemotherapy is a form of anti-cancer drugs which is used to kill cancer cells that are in the bloodstream.
Oh, so it's take medicine only lah. So take medicine, how do I know how long I need to take the medicine?
Well, the type of chemotherapy drug, the route of administration, as well as the duration depends very much on the type and the stage of your cancer.
I heard somewhere about this, they call it radiotherapy.
I think you mean radiotherapy?
Ah, yes, correct, correct, that one.
Now, yeah. Radiotherapy refers to the use of high-energy X-rays in order to kill cancer cells.
Okay.
It is commonly used in the treatment of rectal cancer to shrink the tumour before we perform surgery to remove it.
Mm.
In certain cases of rectal cancer that are not curable, it is also used to control symptoms like pain and bleeding from the tumour.
Okay, alright.